Hello, my name is Jeff, and I'm with EVS. In this video, we're going to be discussing the DMX lighting that we've installed in the kitchen and some of the features it has to offer. Now, we've used equipment from Control 4, from Lutron, American Lighting, as well as Engineering Solutions. Now, I just have an iPad here, which will help simulate some of the different scenarios we'll be talking about, so really don't think you want to sit there and watch me stand in the kitchen for 24 hours while the kitchen does its thing. So, let's get straight into it. Every morning, an hour before sunrise to 8 a.m., the kitchen will turn on to this nice soft purple color. And if you're in the kitchen between an hour before sunrise and 8 a.m. and need some extra light, then you can just use the Lutron keypad we have installed here. We have some very easy to use scenes, bright, medium, and soft. So when you press bright, it will turn on the overhead ceiling lights for us, and it will also brighten up the DMX lighting from about 16% to 80%. Just gives it a little bit of ambiance, gives it, you know, a little bit of character for the kitchen. Now, if it's between an hour before sunrise and 8 a.m. and you press off, the Lutron system will turn off the ceiling fixtures, but it will just lower the DMX lighting back down to that 16%. What that does is it just gives us a little bit of ambiance just for the morning, just in case anybody else needs to use the kitchen. Now, at 8 a.m., the Control 4 system will automatically turn off the DMX lighting for us. And from 8 a.m. till sunset, if you use any of the Lutron scenes, the bright, medium, or soft, it will just turn on the ceiling fixtures for us, and it won't actually turn on any of the DMX lighting for us. Now, during the evening, the DMX lighting will automatically turn on at sunset and between 11 p.m. However, for the evening scene, we've got a slightly different color. It's a little bluish color for us here. And again, if you push any of the Lutron scenes, the bright, medium, or soft, then the Control 4 system will actually brighten up the DMX lighting to about 80% or so. Now, when we're pushing the bright, medium, and soft, then the Control 4 system is checking to see what day of the month it is, what time of the year it is, and things like that. And it's actually gonna change the DMX colors based on what season it is or some of the holidays we have. So for example, for Valentine's Day, we have it turning on automatically to this pink-red color for us. For Halloween, it'll automatically turn on to this yellow color. And for the month of December, it will alternate between green and red every other week. So 1 week it will be green for us, and then the following week, it will be red for us. Now, let's say it's an ordinary day, it's in the evening, and we have our evening colors on here, but we need a little bit of extra light. Let's say we're making our world famous cookies. We've got the mixer on the counter for us, but we need a little bit of extra light. We can ask for some assistance for that. Alexa, turn on the white DMX. So we've got the white DMX lights on now. We can see a little bit better on the kitchen counter. We can see what we're doing. When we're done, we can put the mixer away and we can ask for some extra help with the DMX lights. Alexa, turn off the white DMX.
Okay.
Now again, we'll return it to the previous scene, and because that was our evening bright scene, it returns it to our blue color here. We can also ask for some extra help with the lights from Alexa if we want. Alexa, turn off the DMX.
Okay.
Now we've built several different ways that we can interact with the DMX for this kitchen. Like I said, it will automatically turn it off depending on the time of day, time of month, time of year, things like that. We've also built in some custom voice commands as well for the system. Alexa, turn on the red DMX.
Okay.
And we can also combine our additional colors to that as well too. Alexa, turn on the green DMX.
Okay.
And again, we could also turn off certain colors as well. Alexa, turn off the red DMX.
Okay.
There we go. Now we've also, on top of that, what we have is the ability to turn on and off the custom Control 4 scenes that we were discussing before. So we can ask for some help. Alexa, Turn on morning soft.
Okay.
There we go. It'll also do the other scenes as well too. Alexa, turn on the evening bright.
Okay.
Yeah. And we can also do, Alexa, turn on Halloween bright.
Okay.
There we go. Now, in addition to that, we also have a color wheel with the control for system. So we're able to select different colors. The system itself is able to do more than 16.7 million colors. So if we're using the iPad here, we can select the color wheel and we can select any color that we want. We can also save to presets with a control for interface as well too. Now, let's say that we're having some guests over, we want a bit of a party. We can ask for some help for that as well too. Alexa, it's party time.
Okay, break out the margaritas and let's get wild.
Now, we've obviously got a lot of custom programming that's happening between Control 4, between Lutron, as well as the Engineering Solutions DMX engine. We've got custom responses built in for Alexa for some of our commands here as well. But what she's gone ahead and done is turned on all the lights in the house for the party mode. She's turned on a custom scene that we've got here for the kitchen. And when we're done at the end of the night, we can also ask for some assistance for turning off the lights. Alexa, turn off party mode.
Okay.
And what she's done is she's gone ahead and turned off all the lights in the house, turned off the DMX here in the kitchen. And we've also got some additional features that we've built into the automation side as well. The system has been integrated into the alarm system. So when the alarm system has been activated, the DMX lighting won't actually automatically turn on in the morning or in the evening if it knows that the house has been activated and there's nobody home. Now, in order to make all of this happen, we had to rewire the kitchen. We had to bring in some 5-conductor wiring to each location, one for the bottoms. Each one of the bottoms has its own 5-conductor wire, and then each top location has another 5-conductor wire. So what we ended up having to do was drill a small hole just above the countertops, fish the 2 5-conductor wires through the wall, into the wall, and then from the basement, we had to locate that wall, drill up, grab the wires, and then bring them back to the electrical panel. For the fridge, we had to do a similar thing. We had to drill a small hole, fish over top of the fridge, into the wall space, drop it down into the wall, and again, locate that wall in the basement, drill up from the wall, or into the wall, grab the wires, and bring them back to the electrical panel. For this side, it was a little bit more tricky because we had some additional things that we had to work around. So what we had to do was drill a small hole into the cabinet, into the wall, and then drop it into the mechanical room, and then bring it back to the electrical panel. Once we did that, we had to route the wires through the kitchen cabinets. So we had to run some wires up through the top of the cabinets, down, and then install the DMX lighting underneath as well. Now we've got a lot of customization that happens between Control 4, between the different components of Lutron and the DMX engine from Engineering Solutions, but we had a lot of fun doing the install, and we think the kitchen has some pretty neat features it can offer. My name is Jeff. I'm with EVS. We hope you enjoyed the video.